Hello everyone, hello James. Welcome everybody, my name is Fausto Pugliese, president and founder of Cybertrade University. Hopefully everybody's been enjoying their last day of the month. Hopefully it's been a profitable month and a profitable year for everybody, but now what I'm going to be doing is going to kind of educate you, not just, you know, more or less entertain you, but how to generate significant wealth from home. Now, before we get started, everybody, let me just be able to see if everyone knows how to add. It's very important that we know how to add when it comes to trading. So 1 minus 5 equals what? Can everyone just give me that answer? Negative 4. There you go. All right. Good to see that everyone knows the negatives. All right. Good, good, good. All right, everybody. Before we get started, for everybody could just give me a chat back if you're a student of Cybertrade University, so I could just get an idea of who's a student and who's not. Just write student in the chat room. Just let me know who's... Glenn, good to see you. James, good, good, good. Lewis, David, John, good to see you guys. All right, welcome. Thanks, guys, for supporting Cybertrade University. John's the trading room. Hopefully in the future, Carlos. Okay, well, hopefully we can convert that. And it's always good to have my students here, because one thing I kind of educate my students is that there's a lot of you here that are here to learn about trading, and I always like to my students, because they were you once before, and they like to come back and learn from the people that are taking for the first time, because they realize how uneducated they were. Don't take this the wrong way, but how uneducated they were and what has Cybertrade University has done to change their life, because they, the way the questions that you answer is what they were, and that's what motivated them to get there. And hopefully everyone here will be as excited and motivated to do it themselves too. Now let me just change the slide here, ladies and gentlemen, and we're going to talk about for less than about an hour. I'm basically going to talk about trading and how you could do this from the luxury of your own home. Now, I know everybody hears this phrase. They said, you know what, when it's too good to be true, it usually is. Well, I'm going to tell you, when it's too good to be true, it's usually not. Okay, because the thing is this, I thought that 20 years ago, but for some of you, you know, probably don't know this, but Cybertrade University is based out of here in New York. This is the financial capital of the world. I'm the president and founder of the company. I built a huge, big education school, one of the largest in the world, actually. We have a great staff here. And the reason why people love working at Cybertrade University is because we have a passion to do it. We have the motivation to do it. And, you know, there's just too many people losing money out there. And it's not like something you can go to college and learn. And what happened with me, ladies and gentlemen, is that I started off when I was 22 years old. And over the years, I kind of learned, you know, living in New York, I had friends of mine that were driving Ferraris, they were renting houses in the Hamptons, spending, you know, $100,000, $200,000 on a weekend house. And by the way, this was not their parents' money. They made this money. For some of you, I know a lot of you, the big news in the big news right now on TV is the presidential election. And you could see how the number one, the two biggest people that they're really attacking is mainly Wall Street, you know, including the pharmaceuticals and healthcare. But Wall Street, they want Wall Street to pay more. They talk about the bailouts, they talk about all this stuff. But let me just tell you this. Let's not be hypocrites, because guess what? You know that we make a lot of money. That's why you want to be in this business, okay? You are sick and tired of giving your money to mutual funds. You're sick and tired of stockbrokers. You're sick and tired of paying your forward flow, all that stuff. You want to do it your own. And guess what? When I started, I knew how much money these guys were making, and I wanted a piece of it. But this is the problem. I was an ignorant kid, okay, that didn't want to learn the right way. So what I ended up doing, I ended up being self-taught. And this is probably 95% of the people that are trading the market. And it might be you too. Hopefully not, but it might be you. And, you know, I was self-taught and I blew up three accounts. Well, maybe two and a half. My father, being an immigrant, smart man, always told me, he says, son, enough's enough. I'm not giving you any more money. This is what you need to do, okay? Go work for the best people in the business, no matter what the cost is, okay? No matter what it costs you, go work for somebody, learn from their mistakes, surround yourself with the best traders in the industry, and they will teach you how to trade right. If you really love this job, which I know a lot of you do feel the same, if you really love this job, you gotta learn from the best in the industry. And I did, okay? I went back and forth, I went to New York City, I surround myself with the best traders. And let me tell you this, I made so much money in trading, I was semi-retired at the age of 24. In 2 years, I made so much money that I didn't have to work anymore. Now, obviously, it wasn't very healthy for a 24-year-old to be retired, so I kind of, like, people kept asking me, and that's how I got into the education business, because I had nothing else to do, and I wanted to help people. I wanted to teach people how to do it, you know, and I do both. I do both. I teach and I trade. Now, there's a lot of you here today. There's over 100 to close to 200 people that are going to be here today, and I know every single one of you want the same dream. Social Security's not paying enough. People are not making as much money as they used to, okay? You're hearing it all in the debates with the elections. You're seeing that the market's going up and your account keeps going down. You know, you don't know who to believe anymore. You're stuck watching YouTube channels all day thinking that somebody's gonna give you the holy grail by you learning something for free. Listen, the only thing that's free is a cheese and a mouse trap. So I'm telling you right now, within this presentation, what I'm about to teach you, I'm going to show you the art of trading, and you're going to have to make a decision. Your decision is this. You're going to continue with CyberTrade University and let me prove to you everything that I'm talking about, or you're going to quit your job and you're going to go back and work at McDonald's or whatever it is, or do whatever thing you do. But I'm telling you, if you don't do it right, not only are you going to lose the amount of money you have in your account, but you're going to lose twice that. Because you don't want to make it back. I'm just being very honest. Don't take it against me. That's just how we are in New York. Do it right or don't do it at all. That's like saying, I want to be a doctor. You see the doctor running around the hospital, and then you ask him for his diploma. Oh, where'd you go to school? Oh, I didn't go to school. I want to see if I like it first and see if I make money. So if I can make money here in the hospital, then I could pay for school to learn how to be a doctor. Yeah, that's the guy I want to do brain surgery on one. Well, listen, finance, the same thing. So let's get right into it, ladies and gentlemen. Let's start learning and doing it the right way. Now, before we do that, ladies and gentlemen, now that you know a little history about me, I want to get to know a little bit of history about you, okay? Now, could everybody just give me a chat back and let me know what kind of trader are you? A stock trader, a Forex trader, a swing trader, a day trader, options trader? What kind of trader is everybody? What kind of traders, everyone? Commodities trader, okay, Carlos, some options, Forex, Buffy, okay, stocks, Calvin does some day trading, futures. Okay, and are you guys making money or are you losing money? What are you guys doing? How are you doing? How's it going? Breaking even? No, listen. It's your money. I'm not going to make fun of you. You know, just want to kind of like just get to know a little bit about everyone. Some of you guys are making money. Good. Breaking even, losing, Frank. Okay. Breaking even, losing. And I assume everyone loves the job. Now, and last question. Have any of you guys ever been educated before? You know, and actually taking a course from somebody, actually learned from a mentor, just out of curiosity. Anyone ever actually went out there and learned from a mentor that trained them? Okay, so we got about, Frank, you have, and not my students, Flex. I mean, a few of you, I know if you're a student, don't tell me. Yes, you have a mentor? Okay, so that answers probably like 15 of you. Yes, it did not help Michael. Okay, well, listen, that's a good thing, that I'm glad that you said that, because they're not, you can't look at everybody being a bad mentor, you know, but you know there are good people out there, and that's why you have to keep looking and finding the right guy for you. So that's a good thing. You've taken courses in Italy, but you want to upgrade, Carlos. Okay, well, you're at the right spot because the financial capital of the world is here, okay? All right, so why do 80% of the traders fail? Okay, well, first of all, the questions I just asked you kind of helps answer that. A lot of people are being self-taught. A lot of people don't think want everything for free. And everybody doesn't know that trading is not an investing, it's a job, okay? Now, when I mention that trading the luxury of your home, I'm being very serious. This doesn't require you to go anywhere, okay? You don't have to go, you don't have to trade all day. It's not a full-time job, okay? Trading only, it only requires you to be there an hour a day, right in the morning. Here at Cyber Trading University, at the end of this presentation, I'm gonna invite all of you guys to come and join my trading room and, you know, just do a trial and see what it's like and see students that trade all day long. And what you're gonna find is that we only trade about an hour in the morning and about a half hour in the afternoon. That's about it. And you know what? If you made so much money in the morning, you don't have to trade the afternoon, because that's one of those volatile times. You know, I preferably like to day trade, and I don't know if you guys know the difference, but day trading is the least risky out of all trading. And people like that. A lot of people said, well, I heard the opposite. Well, I'll tell you why. When you day trade, you make your money and you're done. Okay, when you swing trade, now you have a position outstanding, you don't know what's gonna happen overnight with Asia, you know, it could be a catastrophe. You don't know what could happen. I mean, hell, it was a stock symbol, VRX. I don't know if you guys saw VRX. That stock went from $280 down to $25, you know? I mean, in 6 months. So, I mean, you never know what could happen. But day trading is going to teach you what's going to happen on a swing trade in investing. Okay, so that's the way you have to look at it. So a lot of people realize the convenience and how much money you can make, but you gotta start from the bottom. So where most people make most of their money and lose most of their money, the first thing they do is that you gotta find the right brokerage account. Now understand something, we're not a brokerage firm. Okay, we work for you. We're brokerage firm neutral. You know, we do education for about over, I don't know, 40, 50 brokerage firms that we've trained. But I would say half the students, half of you that trade, have the wrong brokerage account. You might have considered getting your brokerage account because they had a great commercial, maybe because they offered some great incentive. But you know what? Incentives doesn't mean, listen, I just went out and bought a brand new car, okay? They had great incentives. And the one that had the great incentives, I didn't even buy that car. It was a great deal, but I'm like, that thing's a hunk of shit. I'm not gonna buy that, excuse my French, but I'm like, I don't care if you gave me things for free. I wouldn't even buy that car, okay? So you buy what you need. And when it comes to trading, a lot of these brokerage firms don't offer you the right tools that you need. They don't have the right trading system. They don't have level three. They don't tell you about the dark pools. They don't show you real-time charts in level two. They don't give you, you have to understand something, and I know we can relate to this. When you drive a car, okay, there's a big difference from driving a car and dealing with the local transportation company, taking a local bus. Dealing with a local bus company, that's like online brokers. Dealing with a direct access brokerage firm that gives you a seat on the exchange, that, ladies and gentlemen, is what we teach you here at Cyber Trading University. Because it's about time. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when you guys are gonna start driving your own car. Well, to do that, you gotta have the right brokerage account. Now, don't tell me, guys, you know, who's your best broker? Like right now, Frank's like, is Short Trade a direct access broker? I don't know. But all I could tell you is this. Everyone write this down. Check with your brokerage firm. Well, just out of curiosity, everyone, just tell me what brokerage firm do you have? Frank, you have Short Trade, right? Trades, Thinkorswim, Interactive Brokers, IB, Quest Trade. Okay, IB is not direct access, okay? Actually, I would never do business with IB. They have cheap tickets, but they have a horrible platform to trade off. I'm thinking about it, not yet. Quest Race, I never heard of them. Robinhood, never heard of them. Option House, I would not trade with them. They're not direct access. Thinkorswim is. Fidelity has terrible service. You know, they don't, you know, I have an account with them for my investing. I called them up. I was on the phone for a half hour. And then by the time they transferred me somebody that knew what he was talking about, it was another 30 minutes. Like I got better things to do than wait on the phone for a half hour to save $3. Options Express, not direct access. I would stay away from them. TradeStation, good brokerage firm. Okay? Good brokerage firm. Anyone else? Ninja, they're pretty good. Ninja's pretty good. Schwab, depends on what kind of account you have with them. Okay? So anyway, my point is this, is that the least, most important thing that you have to be worried about right now is a brokerage account. Okay? Well, let me teach you how to drive, and then we'll worry about buying the car. All right? TD's pretty good. TD's pretty good. I do a lot of education for them. They have a good platform. Thinkorswim is direct access, but they just do things a little bit different. Okay? All right, so now let's talk about, now you know about the how to find, you know, the brokerage firm's account. Now let's talk about finding stocks. Okay? So I think another big failure rate is everybody always find a trading the wrong stocks. I had a guy I was talking to last week, and he told me, he goes, oh, I only trade Amazon. I said, how much are you making? Oh, I make about $100 a day. I'm like, $100 a day? First of all, I'm like, you trade Amazon? What, do you got $500,000 in the market? Oh, no, I got about, you know, 25,000. What the hell are you trading, one share? He goes, well, Amazon's the only stock that has volatility. I'm like, no, it doesn't. Who taught you? He goes, oh, I'm 85 years old, son. I'm older than you. I've been trading for years. I'm like, yeah. And you know what? I was 24 years old, and I made several million dollars, and you're trading only 25,000 in the market? You know? So, I mean, look at the owner of Facebook. You're going to tell him you know better than him? You know, so don't think you can't learn from younger generation. You're trading the wrong stocks. And you know what? At the end of the day, you got no way to find them. So let's talk about finding these stocks. Here at CyberTrade University, what we do is we want to trade stocks that have volatility, okay? And the best place to check is in the big percentage gainers and losers. Now, we have a scanner in our trading room. You get this with brokerage firms also. But what we do is we'll scan through the market, and we'll look for stocks that are making some significant moves today, okay? And you know what? There were a lot of them today. There were a lot of good ones that move. Did you guys see the stock symbol SKYS, by the way? Did you guys see that stock, SKYS? I don't know if anybody has an execution system. SKYS, it started this morning, went from $1.40 all the way to a high of about $2.50. It was up about 100%. You know, I mean, how many of you ever seen a stock up 100%? Not bad. You know, there was a couple other good ones that made some good, some nice moves. How about MDVN? Let me put this one in there. MDVN. Anyone saw that stock? That was a pretty good one. It started this morning at $41, and it's already at almost $47. You know, I mean, up 23%. You know, you probably ask me, well, where did you find it, or how do you do it? I'm going to tell you how we do it, okay? But the thing is this, to make money, you got to learn how to do it the right way. You know, there's a lot of stocks that are moving in the market, but it's all about risk to reward. So where we find these stocks is right here in the big percentage gainers and losers. Here's MDVN. This is a different stock. MDVN. MDVN, you could see how this stock moved up really, really nice. Hold on, where am I? Stock moved really, really, I mean, I'm sorry, LU is the wrong one. Apologize, that's wrong right there. Okay. Lou, this is another one we traded right here. That stock, you could see how, you know, it got from the last hour, went from $4 all the way up to 460. This was actually yesterday, you know. And, you know, and then the next morning, the stock went as almost high as 5, you know. So if you do the math, let's think about this for a second. If you bought a stock at $4, in less than an hour, you sold it at 460. How much money did you make, guys? How much money did you make? What is 4 minus 460? Not the 15%. We don't care about the 15%. 60 cents. Does that sound like a lot? Doesn't sound like a lot. Well, let's times that by 1,000 shares. Calvin, that's $600. Anybody have a calculator? What is 600 times 5 days a week? What's 600 times 5 days a week, ladies and gentlemen? $3,000. 3,000 times 52 weeks a year? If you times 52, if you do that every for 52 weeks, how much money does that come out to be? About $160,000 in less than an hour. Not bad, right, George? You see why we love this job? Okay, you see why we trade stocks like this? Now, what does LEU do? So you can't, well, that's right, Nico. You can't do it every day, but, and I'm not saying that, but how many of you traded LEU yesterday or have ever heard of the company before? You know? That's right, John. Who cares? Money's money, right? That's what we look at here at CyberTrading University. We're looking to trade. Now, how do we know about LEU? Okay? We knew about LEU because it was in the big percentage gainers and losers. It was up 18% on that day, you know, the last hour. Michael, do you trade options? Yes, Michael. We teach our students to trade options. Options is very, very hard, okay? You have a lot to risk when it comes to options. See, when you buy this stock, Michael, you have only two things to beat. You have a very tight spread, and you have a very small commission. When you deal with options, you have a big spread, and you have a commission, and you got to beat time. So the only students that we train here at CyberTrading University to learn how to trade options is after they start making between $100,000 and $250,000 a year, they want to start getting to the $500,000, $1 million a year. Then we teach them how to trade options, where they actually sell the options, or they can't have problems that they can't buy like 10,000, 20,000 shares. So then they'll do it in an options trade. But we do not teach people, which by the way is one of the biggest failure rates of the industry. We don't teach people how to play a poor man playing a rich man's game. So just because you think you can't afford the stock, which is false, everyone can afford to trade a stock. You know, when you deal with options, you got a hell of a lot more to risk. I kind of compare options like anyone here own a house? Anybody here own a house? The people that I know that are very wealthy in this world are the ones that rent, that own homes and they rent them. Okay. So, people that rent their stock out for options, those are the guys that really make money, okay? And I've been doing this for 20 years. And not only that, I'm not trying to knock options, you know, but I'm just going to tell you this. It's the movement of the stock that makes an option move. So if you know why the stock is moving, that will make you a better options trader, okay? But if you can't make money trading the stock, just plain old trade the stock, believe me, you're not going to learn how to, you won't be a good options trader because you got so much more against you. Well, once again, Michael, if you got to be a good stock trader because you got more to risk when it comes to options. And believe me, a lot of my students, we teach options, but we want to teach you options for the right reasons, not for the poor reasons. The binary options, the problem with George with binary options, they're great, but you got to be careful because they don't give you stop order losses, stops on them, okay? Now, let's talk a little bit about how did we know LEU was going to go up or down, okay? Now, I know we have some good options paid traders, and I'm not trying to show any disrespect to anybody regarding about it being, you know, against. I'm not against options. I just know that a lot. I just don't like that people feel that when you have something that's moving in the market, that they think the only way they could trade the stock is an option. And you got to remember, you know, it's a lot riskier to trade an option than just trade the stock. Like, for example, and because the only reason why is this, it's the movement of the stock that makes an option move. Remember that. Now, let's talk about the stock LEU, okay? That had a nice move. Does anybody know why LEU went up? Why did LEU go up? How do you know when stocks go up and go down, everybody? Can everyone answer that question? How do stocks go up and go down? Supply and demand, right? Okay, so how do you know if a stock's going up or down? How do you see supply and demand? Buyers and sellers, okay? So, have any of you guys ever heard of level three before? Ever heard of level three? Okay, no, there's a lot of you guys here, so any of you else, anyone else here? Okay, well, I'm going to teach you what it is. Have any of you guys ever heard of high frequency trades? HFTs, high frequency trades. Oh, John, you heard from me from 2 years ago. Okay, good. All right, so basically, high frequency trades control 70% of the volume of a stock. Okay, so you probably heard of algorithms, all that good stuff. Okay, so what makes these things move is these big block orders. Now, I don't know if you guys know this, but let me ask you this. If I was able to tell you that I could show you where 70% of the volume of a stock that you're trading is going, what is that worth to you? If you could see 70% of the buyers and sellers, if they're on the bid or the offer, what is that worth to you? Yes, the most computers from England. George, I don't know who told you that, but that's not really, that's not true. It's all over the world. It's a bonus. It means a lot. Okay. John says you'll know the direction. Okay. Lots if it's fast money. Okay. All right. Well, John, we didn't get to that yet. And this is, and who here wants to, who here would like to see level three in action? Anybody here want to see level three in action? All right, so at the end of this presentation, ladies and gentlemen, everybody is more than welcome to join me for 3 days. All right, for 3 days, you could join me in my professional trading room, and I'll show it to you live what it looks like, okay? But I got to show it to you. I can't show you in 10 minutes, but I'm going to explain to you what it is. Here are your buyers. Here are your sellers. The buyers are the bid is the buyers. The ask is the sellers. So what you're seeing is all the orders out there. So what's happening is when you're looking at the orders, you're looking, here's the price. And right here at the stock right now is trading at $5.32. On the bid side, you're getting 200 shares looking to be bought at $5.31, 2,700 at, let me get my little pointer out here so you guys can follow along. So you get, you know, you can see all the buyers out here. Everyone's got their limit orders, okay, what they want to buy. You guys put limit orders out there? Anybody put a limit order out there on a trade? Okay, so basically these are all the limit orders around the world, okay? And on the sell side, you can see all these people looking to sell, 200, 300, 900. And then when you get somewhere around $5.49, you know, compared to everybody out there, between 549 and 550, you get a 5,000 share seller, a 14,000 share seller, and a 3,000 share seller. So just between those two right there, you're talking close to almost 25,000 shares that there's a bunch of people out there selling within that range of $5.50. And, you know, and that's a significant difference, you know, 15 cents away. So you're seeing where the orders are. Okay, that's a great, great question. How is level three different from level two? It's a huge difference. You're getting 20 times more data. Level two is only showing you the best bid and the best offer. It's not showing you all the bids and all the offers. So level two is obsolete. It's been obsolete for over 5-6 years, okay? Let me tell you, do you pay for level two? Anyone here pay for level two? No, you don't pay for it, John? You know why you don't pay for it? Because it's garbage. It doesn't do anything. Why would somebody, if everybody got something for free, wouldn't everybody use it? Of course they are. So what, do you think market makers are going to tell you what they want to buy and sell the stock? Does anyone here have level three? Anybody have level three? Because guess what? Level three does cost money. It does cost money. And when I used to use level three 20 years ago, I used to pay over $1,000 a month for it. Now you're probably falling off your chair and said, like, you pay $1,000? Why would I pay $1,000 when I get level two for free? Because the only thing that's free is a cheese and a mouse trap. Okay, and let me explain to you. Without level three, you're trading blind. You're not seeing all the institutional orders out there. If you read any of the books, they always tell people, oh, you can't see these orders. You know, they're not allowed. Of course you could see it. You know why people don't have it? Two reasons. Number one, they don't want to pay the $15 for it because they think level two is, you know, is free. Why should I pay $15 for something? Because no one ever explained it to them. And number two, if your brokerage firm doesn't offer it, is because they don't want you to know what's going on out there because they're trading against you. You see, ladies and gentlemen, you've been dealing with public transportation your whole life. You've just been introduced now that you have access to drive your own car. Are you ready to start stepping it up and start driving your own car? Or are you still happy dealing and paying and dealing with the public transportation and the guy that's sitting next to you that smells every day going to work? Because you know what? You don't want to pay the extra $15 a month to drive your own car. You got to remember something. You're doing this as a career. You got to do it right. You're getting into the business that you can make a lot of money. You are your own boss, but you can't be successful by not having the right tools. How do I get level three? That's an excellent question. And this is what you're going to have to do. You're going to have to join me in my trading room, and I will show you where to get it. I'm not going to tell anybody here where to get it. Not because I'm being, you know, rude or I need your $37, because you know what? If you go there and buy it, you'll do more damage than good. You're going to end up, because what's going to happen, you're going to use it, you're going to try it, and you're not going to know what you're reading, and you'll end up doing more harm than good. That's why. But If you don't want to start trading blind and you don't want to be part of the 80 to 90% failure rate, let me explain to you how this thing works. Does anybody here use a chart? Anybody here know how to read charts? Anybody here know how to read a chart? Okay. That's it? Only three people? Come on, Michael, what about you? Lucy? John? Don't be shy, guys. Ted, do you know how to read TJ, Tom, Vilmer, you guys know how to read? Okay, good, good. You got me nervous out there for a second. If you can't read a chart, you better go back to public. You better give your money to a mutual fund. All right, don't even consider it. All right, so here you have a stock, right? Here's a one-minute chart, LEU, right? This is a stock that we traded today. Yesterday. LEU and LEU, right? So most people look at the stock and like, wow, the stock went from $1.20 to about $6 in less than a month. They're like, wow, how did that do that, you know? And then you're looking back here in April, like, oh yeah, look at that stock hit a resistance levels. You know, why did the stock stop? Why would a stock hit a resistance level? Because a chart tells you so? Does anyone know where the chart gets its data from? How does a chart know to make a support and resistance levels? Can anyone answer that? For all the chart readers out there. How does a chart know to make a support and resistance levels? Where does a chart get its data from? Supply and demand, buyers and sellers, right? Do you see buyers and sellers on a chart? You guys see buyers and sellers on a chart? No, but you know what? You can. You can with level three, and I'll show you why. Level three is going to show you where all the big block orders are. What makes a support and resistance levels is orders. So level three will show you all the orders out there. Like, for example, you look at over here and you're seeing how many shares are out there. 2,000, this is Twitter, okay? For some of you saying, oh, what's with the cheap stocks? Fausto, you don't trade brand name? Of course I trade Twitter. Here's one right here. 2,000, 1,000, 1,900. And then we look over here, you know, 10,000, you know, for 180,000 shares. You know, you can see 10 orders. You know, so what we look for when we trade, and what I'll show you in the real live market conditions, is that when you trade, you want to see these big block orders. When you look at a support and resistance levels, guess what? What makes a support and resistance level is these big orders. So you could have a game plan before they even happen. Isn't that great if you knew you were coming up to a resistance level, that there was a big seller out there so you could prepare and get out before it gets to that guy? And wouldn't it be great to be going out there and knowing to see if there's a big order out there and someone's buying it from him? John says, you cannot tell if they're shorting or buying a stock. John, does it matter? An order is an order. You know, a support, could you tell if somebody's shorting and buying on a chart? I mean, does a chart tell you if it's a short or if someone's buying or selling it? No, it's irrelevant. It's not your problem. What your problem is that you want to make money. If someone's covering a short, regardless, it's a demand. If somebody is buying, you know, to cover, I mean, it's or selling it because they want to short it, regardless, it's a supply. It's the same thing. Can these fake big orders be on level three? Well, you know what? Let me ask you this. Does your brokerage firm let you put fake orders out there? Yin, are you allowed to put fake orders with your brokerage firm with no money out there? And will they let you do that? You're a small fish. That's not the question. The question is, will your brokerage firm let you put a fake order out there? Yes or no? But the big fish can. No, that's not true. The big brokerage firms cannot put fake orders out there. Okay, they don't own, listen, the brokerage firms are traders, all right? The exchange is given the privilege to trade in their markets. They can't put fake orders out there. Those are all real orders. And this is what I'll do. I will personally guarantee that you come and trial you come in my trading room, and I'll show you a big order. And this is what we'll do. We'll go out there. You think it's fake? Go out there and execute it, guy. And if I'm right, okay, you take my full-blown course. If you're wrong, I'll give you my course for free. Okay? And I'll teach you how to trade for the next year. If it's fake. Nico, spoofing is, you know, what was going on with, you know, with Dodd-Frank took care of that. And poofing, the spoofing is the least of your problems. You know, you're allowed to cancel orders. You know, aren't you allowed to cancel an order? So that's the way you have to look at it. But you know what? You know what's great about the comments that you guys are making? Is that every single one of you are very skeptical. Right? Aren't you skeptical? Because you know what? Somebody told you something differently. Okay? People are going out there and you think like, oh, this is paper trading, this is fake trading. How do you know those are real orders? How do you know if they're canceling it? You know what? Come and join my trial for $37 for 3 days, okay? And if you not, and I guarantee your money back if I can't show you not one, but several of them over and over and over again and show you real stocks that are moving. What's the worst thing that could happen, right? So we have a lot of students here. I have a lot of my students here. And my students, guys, who's here a student? Who's here a student of CyberTrade University? Lewis, okay. Lewis, listen to what these people are saying. Basil, listen to them. James, remember you were them when you first started, okay? And listen to the questions that they're coming up with. They really think, Lewis, are these fake orders? Sebastian, they're not, right? You guys have been students for a long time. And remember, the great thing about you guys being here, and the reason why I love my students to come back, is I want them to see what they were like of them being skeptical. And hopefully, you guys being here for the first time will listen to the students that are here and will realize that, hey, guys, this is for real. This is not a joke. This is a great job in the world. And if you think it's skeptical, come in the trade room, see what it's all about. So the thing is this, there are a lot of big orders out there and you got to know how to follow them. James Winslow, I was just as skeptical. C2 teaches you to be a better trader, but it takes time and determination. There is no magic formula here. John, thank you very much for sharing that. I appreciate that. And if any other students could tell everybody else, because you know what? Let me explain to you how we work here at CyberTrade University. The way we work is what we're looking for is some people that are serious traders, okay? We're looking for serious traders that want to learn how to trade. Who's Cameron? She was one of my instructors. And I'm happy for her. There you go. A fellow instructor at CyberTrade University started their own company. So, you know, we've got to understand something. We've been doing this for 20 years. And we have several instructors that work for us and have started their own companies, you know, and that's what we do, ladies and gentlemen. Our students have started their own companies. We teach you how to go out there and teach other people. So we don't hold anyone, you know, hostage. But the thing is, you gotta learn how to trade. You gotta learn how to play the market, you know? And what we look for at CyberTrade University are committed people that want to do this as a career, because if you know what you're doing, you're going to make all of us a good teacher and all of us great traders. How come you do not use candlesticks, Paul? I use candlesticks for birthday cakes all the time. You know? But all kidding aside, candlesticks don't work for day trading. It works for swing trading and investing. Okay? All right? But they do work good for birthday cakes. Anyway, finding support and resistance levels. So, keeping things a little bit more simple, if you eliminate a lot of the candlesticks, let's call it, what I am and what I teach my students what to be is a modern tape reader. So you get to read the tape. You get to see what's going on. Now, does anybody know what a tape reader is? Anybody know what a tape reader is? decades ago? Right, that's right, Paul. You know, basically a tape reader, it's a little bit different. Tape reading really hasn't changed. I'm a tape reader. A tape reader, basically, you know, what we're doing is we're looking at orders, okay? It's actually, you know, a lot easier today in today's times because now you get to see it. So I'm a tape reader. I get to see, you know, I mean, you know, obviously you're seeing, what you're seeing right there is a little tape. But when you watch CNBC and you're following the orders come across, it's the same thing. So I teach my students how to be tape readers, basically the modern way of trading. So when you're seeing the orders coming in and you're seeing support resistance levels, basically, you know, you're kind of just seeing where the block orders are moving. All right, that's the way how it goes. Now, as a trader, I want you to understand that what do we learn so far is that we've learned that most people fail by having the wrong brokerage account. A lot of people fail because they were self-taught. A lot of people fail because they don't know how to play the game. So what have we learned so far other than having the right brokerage firm account? We've learned exactly what high-frequency trades are. We've learned that 70% of the volume is controlled by those stocks. You've got to know, you know, these are all the things that we've learned when it comes to trading. But the thing that you have to understand most is that when we trade, we only work part-time. Listen, the reason why we're doing an event right now at 12 o'clock, you know, because this is the slow time of the market. There's nothing going on. You know, most of the big movers like Twitter this morning, when it went from $18.50 to $18, you know, look at that. In a matter of what, 30 minutes? It's not, you know, that's where the money's being made, guys. That's where it's being done. That's where it's being done. Timing during the day, iceberg orders, you know, these are the things that are going to help you knowing where to get in and where to get out. Let's look at this example of a Twitter trade, okay? So everybody see this right here? Look what happened here at Twitter. 18, 18. What is the stock supposed to do at 18, right? Well, this, if that, what happened in that past is this big buyer, you know, at this big buyer right there of 18s. 10,000, 5,000, 3,000. Those are the orders that you have to look for, ladies and gentlemen. Big, big support at 18. Because then what happens, if you look what happened here at 10 o'clock when the volume kicked in, the stock goes from 18 all the way to 18.20. So, you know, what makes support and resistance levels are big block orders. That's right. Elton, it's lunchtime on Wall Street. Tony says, I remember taking that that trade in phase three. Easy money. Thanks, Fausto. Tony, more than welcome. Thank you very much, Tony. And you know what, Tony? How long have you been trading with Cyber Trade University for? How long have you been a student for? Long time student. And he's still here. Now, Tony, you know, let me ask you a question. About 4 or 5 years, okay? And Tony, if you could share with the audience a little bit, you know, your experience with Cyber Trade University, let me just ask you a question. How long does it take to learn how to trade, you know, how long does it take to learn how to trade? See, just get Tony's question here. Took him about 3 to 4 months, okay? And was that with or without education? With. And how long you think it would take somebody to learn without education? Well, probably as long as it's been a student. Okay, well, that's basically what's going on as when it comes to trading, ladies and gentlemen. So the thing is this. We have colleges for a reason. If it was easy we would, to be a doctor or a lawyer or whatever you want to be, we wouldn't need colleges, and it would be charging you $60,000, $70,000 a year to go there. You have the opportunity right now of having the greatest job in the world staring you right in the face. And I could tell you this, there will never be free college, okay? It's just not gonna happen. Someone's gonna have to pay for it, okay? So you gotta learn how to play, the game right. Don't lose this opportunity. Now let's talk about time in sales. Anybody know what time in sales is? Germany has free colleges, John goes. Well, John, listen, you think you have a free college? No, you don't. It's coming out of your taxes, okay? So there's nothing free in this world other than the cheese and the mousetrap, okay? So everyone knows the time in sales. Okay, so look at time in sales. Now, I want you guys to understand the way time in sales gets its orders from, time in sales gets its orders from transactions that are actually happening. That's where the transactions comes in. So the thing is this, you see a lot of these green orders? Everybody see those green orders out there? Those green orders, what that means is trades that are going off. Trades that are going off on the offer. You see how the stock is going up? Okay, so the chart is getting its data from the time in sales. If you could just see the time in sales, you'll have a better direction where the stock is going. So if you get a lot of greens, you know the stock is going up. You get a lot of reds, you know the stock is going down. So you don't really need to be a chart analyst, because let me tell you this, charts don't make you a good trader. And why is that? Because when you look at an example like this, the problem that we have is that everybody wants to learn every single indicator out there. Now, indicators work for swing trading, investing. It does not work for day trading. Indicators are laggers, okay? And then what happens, they make you think too much. If you kept things more simple, and if you just follow the orders and see where support and resistance levels, your answers will be, your questions and your trades will be better and smarter. What about black and purple? Black, you know what? It's just the way we color code things. Purple means orders going below the bid, and yellows mean they're going above the ask, and black is just the back screen. There's orders in between the bid and ask, John. Just a color way we color coordinate. We go into detail of telling you what those are in class. Anybody ever heard of the KISS method? Just keep it simple, okay? All right, so how do you become a better trader? Well, most important thing is that you have to look yourself in the mirror and say, are you willing to make a commitment and that you really like trading? And if you're giving your money to a mutual fund or a stockbroker, you're probably losing your patience with them. Because what they're doing is, even if they show you 5 or 10% return on your money, they're making 5, 10% a day on your money. And if you really knew how much money they were making on your money, you're like, what the hell do I need them for? I could just do it myself. And you know what? No one's gonna care about your money better than you. You know, you just gotta learn how to play the game. What we do here at CyberTrade University is we teach you how to become a market maker. Well, you know, George, you really need, you know, you got to have the passion and you got to have the right mentor. And most importantly, George, I know I'm a great trader, okay? I'm a 12-time world champion. I beat every school in the world. I got nothing else to prove. What you have to look at, George, is can Fausto teach George to be a good trader? And if you listen to some of the students, because they're in a trading room right now, watch and see if they make money. That's the way you have to look at it. Well, we always say, John, is that the educated will always beat the uneducated. So if you're the uneducated trader, let me tell you, those are the ones we want to trade against. We can't beat Goldman Sachs. We can't beat Merrill Lynch. Believe me, they online brokers will never give you the access of what you need to be successful, but there's just 10 million people in this world trading. So if I had an opportunity to compete against someone that's uneducated, believe me, I'm all chips in, because that's the guy I want to compete against. And that's why a lot of you are not making the money that you're making, because no one ever taught you how to do it right. You have to understand something. We need to learn before we can earn, and you got to have a mentor. You see, what we do at Cyber Trading University is we teach you how to play the game. And that's what you have to look at it. You got to have a mentor, you know? And, you know, having a mentor is going to help you become a better trader. That's the way you have to look at it. Now, quick question for some of you here. Any of you guys ever been in a professional trading room? Any of you guys ever been in a professional trading room? Or been on the floor of the exchange or any of that stuff? Anyone ever been there? Okay. Would you guys like to see what it's like being in a professional trading room? So what I'd like to do, ladies and gentlemen, is I'd like to introduce you, all of you. And let me just share my screen with you. Give me a second here. What you're looking at right here, ladies and gentlemen, is our trading room. So I'm going to play a little music for them, wake them up a little bit. Right now, what you're looking at is these are all our students, and we have a couple of trial members in there. And they're basically, what they're doing is they're kind of pretty much taking off right now because a lot of the stocks made their big moves. But what we're doing here is we're trading. And if I scroll up here, ladies and gentlemen, you could see here that we started opening up the room at 8:30 a.m. And you could see all the students, Grant Brockway, Deborah Fine, Mariola, Agatha, these are all great traders. And they're getting ready to start accessing their trades. And you could see that already started trading in the pre-market. And basically, you could see it, like they traded stocks like GSN and CPXX. And you know, then when we get to a little bit of a moment of silence at around 9 o'clock, where we do a live audio broadcast. Everybody can hear my audio. Let me just bring this up really quick here. And we have our instructors in there, our other traders, and we're just trading together. And we're getting into positions, and we're like here, like Dana made 75 cents in RH, okay? RH was a really good mover. Do you know what 75 cents is, ladies and gentlemen, on 1,000 shares? 75 cents. Right here at the open at 9:30, this stock went from $40.60 until 11 o'clock, went all the way up to $43.40. Restoration Hardware Holdings, I don't even know what the hell that company is. Okay? It is, Ellen. It's a great trading day. You know, it's a very good trading day. You wouldn't take that? You know? You know, a lot of these traders did really, really well. Dana also made another 65 cents in LEU, you know? LEU, let me show you that trade. LEU right here, look at that trade right here. Right at the open, stock goes from $4.60 in less than 45 minutes, goes to $5.45. Stock moved a dollar in less than 45 minutes. Anybody buy 1,000 shares of that? Anyone have a problem with that? You know? So, and now they're trading, look at that, from 10 o'clock. You could see right from here. From 10 o'clock, they were trading MDVN. What's that stock doing? Oops, spelled it wrong. Hold on a second. From 10 o'clock, they were trading it. Look at the clock right here in the bottom. They started at $43. Look where it is right now. 46. Now, how do we find these symbols? The question is, great question. Right here in our top 20 list. All these stocks, look at that. MDVN is the fourth biggest percentage gainer of the NASDAQ market. This is where we find them. So this is what we do, ladies and gentlemen. We trade these stocks and we make money together, and that's what we do. So anybody here want to log in and see what it's all about? Anybody here want to be part of it and see pre-market trading and see students getting in and out of positions, making, you know, hundreds and thousands of dollars a day? I know that sounds crazy and ridiculous, but you got to see it to believe it. I attended 5 days last week, Carlos. Okay, good. I'm glad you enjoyed it. So if you want to start learning today, this is what I ask. For $37 with your money back, guaranteed. The $37, all it does is cover the, all it covers, ladies and gentlemen, is the webinar technology. If you're not happy, we'll give you money back, okay? But log in a trading room, and if you call in right now, we're gonna do a bonus. If you call in right now, we'll throw an extra 2 days, so you get 5 days, okay? So you can go online, or you can call in and get 5 days. So just click on this link right here and we'll get you registered for it. Now the thing is this, guys, does anyone here know what day trading or swing trading is all about? Because if you want to see the real truth behind it, come and log in the room and see what it's about. And we'll go from there. Thank you very much, Carlos. Telling you, very good instructors. Any questions, guys, in the meantime? Any questions? Just going to put the clock up here because we're going to be closing out in 5 minutes. The promotions will get closed in 5 minutes. Rich says not yet. Okay. John, you have no questions? Good. All right, so if you, trading room is from 8:30 to when? It's from 8:30 to 4:30 in the afternoon, Eastern time. It's all day long, all day. Now, James, thank you very much. It's definitely worth the $37. Thanks for sharing that. One trade in the trading room pays for the whole year. It sure does, right? So why would you not sign up? Why would you not come? What's the worst thing that can happen to you? You spent five cups of Starbucks coffee to be in the room that you could pay for it. You still have my book after 2 years? You're my clock. John, how well has that clock been treating you? Well, I can't believe it. Thing's still working. That's awesome. Richard, you know what? Talk to an education advisor. They'll tell you about after 5 days, but that's not, you know what? It's irrelevant. If I told you it cost $1,000, okay, but I'm teaching you how to make $1,000 a day, would it matter? You know, it's irrelevant. It's like buying real estate here in New York City. When you tell people that, the rent here is $500 a square foot, they're like, well, we only pay $5 a square foot in Alabama. I'm like, you know what? The difference between Alabama and New York City is that you got 4 million people walking in front of your door, you know? So it's all relative. So don't even worry about it. That's the least of your problems. Get in the room and see what it's like. Carlos, you know what? Once again, talk to an education advisor and they'll tell you how to move forward with that. But you know what? If you want to do it right, yes, you got to learn how to do it right. But for some people here, let me explain something to you, everybody. Being in the trading room, if you let me teach you and my instructors, okay, show you how to trade,
you help us and my students become better traders, because we're looking for a few good traders that want to learn and take this seriously, that want to be part of a family, because we're always looking for new recruits, people that want to trade and make money with other traders. If you're that guy that wants to stay home and think you know everything else, and you know, then this is not for you, okay? But if you're looking for a good group of traders that make a lot of money, and you feel that you can contribute because you got a passion to it, then we want you to come and join us. So come in and stop by and see how it goes. Carlos, you know what? You don't really need that much. You don't really need that much time. I mean, the courses, we only do the course for about an hour a day. You don't really need that much. How many in the group? You know, it runs between 100 to about 200, you know? Richard? Any other questions? How do you need level 3 to learn to continue? Sam, if you let, you know what? When you get in the trading room, you'll see us use it, and then you'll make a decision when after talk to an education advisor if you need it or not. But I got to show you how to utilize it first. No problem, Biffy. Well, you know what? Just register for the trial, and you got all the time in the world. Yes, James, and that's another thing. Telling Carlos, and this goes for everybody. When you're a student, we record everything. It's on your dashboard. You get live trading journals. You got to remember, there's not that many people in this world, schools, that would tell you this. But we have been in business for over 20 years. We're one of the longest, oldest running schools in the industry, okay? And we're not a franchise, okay? We're not like a McDonald's. We're a boutique firm, okay? Where a school where everybody is working in one location. We have, you know, we have a lot of employees that work here, and you know, we all are out to one mission, and that's all to make money together. Frank, I trade anything the only thing I don't trade, Frank, is anything under a dollar. Okay, it's the only thing I don't trade. Because then we get in 10s and 16s, and I only trade NASDAQ national stocks. So, you know, if it's $2 or if it's $80, money's money, you know? But I could tell you this, Frank, it's all about risk to reward. So when you go out there and trade, if you're looking to make $500 a day, you know, if you could do it trading a $5 stock versus a $50 stock, I'd rather trade the $5 stock. Well, thank you, James. James is making a very good comment. You'll love it. You'll have to really be ready to do the learning curve. It does take at least 3 months, at least for a beginner such as I. And that's true. And the thing is this. Everybody here wants to... make the quick buck, okay? Let me tell you what we do here at Cyber Trading University. We don't tell you what to buy and sell. We teach you how to buy and sell on your own. We'll like the captain of the ship, we'll take you where it is, and then we'll show you how to fish, but you gotta catch it at the end of the day. But the thing is this, before you go out there and try to learn how to do it, why don't you see people actually that make money doing it and try it out and go from there? What is our business model? To trade with our students and make money with you guys. All right. Okay, guys, so we're out of time. I got to get ready to teach a class in a few moments. So in the meantime, is your the opportunity's there for you. Money back guarantee, $37, 3 days if you buy it online, 5 days if you call up, and then you go from there. Why is it level two? One question, TJ says, why has level 2 gone bad? Because it doesn't show you all the data. It only shows you the best bid and best ask. It doesn't show you all the orders out there. That's the reason.
What about the best brokerage firm to use? Why not get the big fees? Well, Tom, you know what? Call our office, tell a brokerage firm, talk to one of our education advisors, and they'll tell you everyone's a case by case basis. You're in different countries, different margin requirements, different types of traders. You know, there's about two or three I could recommend for you, but I don't know what kind of trader you are and how much money you have in the market. I don't know, you know, I don't know what kind of trading, you know, where you're from. So that's why, you know, here at CyberTrade University, we do the things what we do, and that's, we treat everybody on a case-by-case basis. But just remember one thing, ladies and gentlemen, you got to learn before you can earn. Thank you very much, everyone, for being here. Hope you enjoyed the presentation. Look forward to seeing you all in the next hour. Oh, by the way, one last thing before you go. If you do register now, we're going to be doing a live audio broadcast at 2:30 of what to trade in the afternoon. So if you start your trial today, make sure you get in there before 2:30 so you can start seeing and get the feel of it, because today's been a really good day in the market. Been a lot of big movers. So don't forget to miss that audio broadcast of what we're going to trade going into the afternoon. All right, guys? Thanks, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your presentation. Look forward to seeing you in the trading room.
So immediately you're calling, yeah, like, how long have you been a student? So I was like 4 to 5 years. Like, oh, how long did it take you to be profitable? Like, oh, like 3 or 4 months.
Who's Carlos?
We were just talking about that. He's John's guy. He's poor right now. He's going to take the courses in late April, though. John spoke to him yesterday. I think John, I'm pretty sure John already pitched that. I don't think he has a lot of money at all. Like, he sounds very interested, and he's like sticking with it, and he gave a good testimonial. And honestly, John just said off the bat, he doesn't have money.
Yeah.
So it's one of those. He's on top of it. He spoke to him very detailed yesterday. I updated the notes for that guy also, just so you could see the top title where he can't pay to leave people.
Yeah.
Cyber Trading University, the world leader in education, traders, and investors, has over 15 years of experience teaching students how to make the most of their portfolios in volatile markets. Cyber Trading University is the best educational opportunity to become a successful trader. Cyber Trading University offers many benefits. Class content, webinars, instructors, live class interaction, customer support, customer loyalty, security, and many more. Cyber Trading University prides itself on working with the best brokerage firms and software companies in the business to offer free demos and platform tools. This gives our students the ability to fully leverage their trading tools in their daily market routines. It's time to trade in volatile markets and learn Wall Street secrets. Register today at www.cybertradinguniversity.com or call 877-70-CYBER to speak with an educational advisor. Sign up for a free introductory course in stocks, Forex, options, technical analysis, swing trading, and much more. Cyber Trading University, the world leader in education, traders, and investors, has over 15 years of experience teaching students how to make the most of their portfolios in volatile markets. Cyber Trading University is the members' best educational opportunity to become a successful trader. Cyber Trading University offers many benefits. Class content, webinars, instructors, live class interaction, customer support, customer loyalty, security, and many more. Cyber Trading University prides itself on working with the best brokerage firms and software companies in the business to offer free demos and platform tools. This gives our students the ability to fully leverage their training tools in their daily market. market routines.